Good morning, you're watching Doordarshan News and this is the news for Hearing Impaired. I am Nancy Kohli and with me is Smriti. Let's begin with the news in detail. North Korea conducted its fifth nuclear test today after meteorological agencies reported a surface-level seismic tremor near the North's known test site that indicated it was its most powerful yet. South Korean President Park Geun-hye in Laos PDR after a summit of Asian leaders said it was a nuclear test. She said North Korean leader Kim Jong-un was showing maniacal recklessness in completely ignoring the world's call to abandon his pursuit of nuclear weapons. Isolated and aggressive North Korea conducted its fourth nuclear explosion in January and followed it up with a series of missile tests despite severe United Nations sanctions. On Monday, it fired three medium-range missiles during a G20 summit in China that was attended by U.S. President Barack Obama and other world leaders. Obama held meetings with the South Korean president and Japanese prime minister after the missile test and said Washington needed to maintain a sense of urgency within the international community on sanctions against North Korea. Japan also described the seismic event as a nuclear test. If a nuclear test is confirmed, it could have been timed by North Korea to coincide with the anniversary of its 1948 foundation as a republic. Its continued testing despite sanctions presents a severe challenge to Barack Obama in the final months of his presidency and could become a factor in the U.S. presidential elections in November. Japan's prime minister said a nuclear test could not be tolerated. Japan's foreign minister lodged a protest and Tokyo also sent military jets to begin measuring for radiation. China's environment ministry began emergency radiation monitoring along its borders with North Korea in the northeast China. Prime Minister Narendra Modi talked tough on terror at the global stage, advocating in most stern words strong action against the countries which indulge in promoting terror as an instrument of their state policy. Without naming Pakistan but leaving no doubt as to where his direct broadside was targeted, Prime Minister Modi reached out to the international community, calling for collective efforts to combat the challenge of terrorism. Addressing the East Asia Summit, the Prime Minister called for isolating and imposing sanctions on Pakistan. The Prime Minister wrapped up his two-day visit to Laos PDR yesterday. President Pranab Mukherjee's assent to the historic 122nd Constitutional Amendment Bill on the GST is a major step towards rolling out a new indirect tax regime which the centre wants it to come into effect from 1st of April next year. The passage of the bill will pave the way for setting up a GST council that will decide the tax rate, cess and surcharges. The goods and services tax is a single indirect tax which will subsume most of the central and the state taxes such as the value added tax, the excise duty, service tax, central sales tax, additional customs duty and special additional duty of customs. A dawn to dusk Karnataka band has been called by the pro-Kannada outfits today to protest against Supreme Court's direction to release Kaveri River water to Tamil Nadu. This is the second band that the state is bracing for in less than a week's time and the fourth this year. The emotive Kaveri issue is being supported by several organizations, unions and political parties. Keeping security of students in mind, schools and colleges have declared a holiday. Meanwhile, police have arrested protesters and blocked the international airport. There seems to be no end to the troubles and controversies surrounding the Aam Aadmi Party. The latest issue confronting an embattled Aam Aadmi Party comes from Delhi High Court judgment quashing Aam Aadmi Party government's decision to appoint 21 MLAs as parliamentary secretaries. The court observed that appointments were made without getting an approval from the Lieutenant Governor. The Indian Oil Corporation will today send 7 tankers of diesel and kerosene to Tripura via Bangladesh for the first time to avoid fuel crisis in the northeastern state as the dilapidated condition of National Highway 44 in Assam has made the transportation difficult. In the first consignment, 7 tankers will be flagged off from Guwahati Depot to Tripura via Bangladesh. It will carry 84,000 litres of kerosene and diesel. The second consignment of 10 tankers will depart from Assam capital next week through Bangladesh. On to sports news now. New world number one, Angelique Kerber, proved a cut above Denmark's Caroline Wozniacki to reach Saturday's US Open final, where she'll take on Czech 10 seed Karolina Pliskova. Kerber completed a 6-4, 6-3 victory to reach her maiden final in New York. And with that, it's a wrap on this edition of the news. Thanks for being with us.